Good evening, everybody, from Disney's Magic Kingdom. So we're here today to primarily focus on kind of like what Halloween fall things you can do when it's not a Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party night, because tonight is not a party night. So I'm just gonna be showing you guys what kind of treats you can get. Fall is my favorite time of the year, so you better believe I'm gonna be showing you guys all the decorations and all the fall-y stuff we have going on at the Magic Kingdom. So come along with us. Have enchantment going on right now, so some cute little fireworks. I took the much less crowded view for the fireworks. So there's plenty of Halloween merch inside of Star Traders, so we're gonna go in here and see what kind of cute Halloween merch we can find. So as we enter, there is tons of Hocus Pocus merch here.
Oh my gosh, how adorable.
This is too cute. So this is a very cute little decorative piece. You can actually put a little like tea light candle in there and it'll kind of light it up. This would be a very cute little decorative piece in your home. And if you like it, it is going for $24.99. So if you're a Hocus Pocus fan, Disney has you covered. And this Hocus Pocus spirit jersey is too cool. We have little Winifred here, Winifred Sanderson. Oh, this is too cool. Let's see what's on the back.
Oh, and it says, tonight we fly.
Oh, I love it.
But it does get super hot. So they also have this similar design here in a shirt, tonight we fly. And behind them is Jack Skellington. This is kind of cute. It's like a little two-layer shirt. It's a little on the thicker side, but it is very cute.
Nothing on the back of this shirt, though. They also have some really adorable little Hocus Pocus tumblers. Oh, I love the sparkles. Trouble is brewing. More like trouble is brewing when I don't have my coffee. And this little tumbler is $34.99. So if you're a Hocus Pocus fan, come over here, get this Hocus Pocus merch before the season ends. We also have some really cute little gummy candy corn here. Very giftable. You can even put a little to and from here. And then inside is little gummy candy corn. How adorable. And they also have it in this design too that says trick or treat. And these little things are going for, these little things are going for $9.99. And these are perfect for your little trick-or-treaters if you're having a little candy bowl to leave out. But I'll be honest, if you're that house that leaves out a candy bowl, you already know. That one kid's gonna pick up the whole bowl and just dump it in their little trick-or-treat bag. But this is so cute. Let's see how much this bowl is. Okay, not too bad. It's $39.99. This bowl is not bad and it is so adorable. So I've seen this little silly symphony design on the shirts. Now I'm seeing it in sweatshirts. This is a very, very cute little sweatshirt here, guys. Better yet, it kind of has like a cropped design and it's not too thick. So I feel like you can wear it in the floor to fall, I'm gonna call it, because it's really thin material. And then this one is going for $39.99. So candy corn is the type of thing where either you love it or you absolutely hate it. So our first stop of the night is going to be at Anti-Gravity's. They have a candy corn milkshake. I have never tried it. It's actually more of like a corn flavored milkshake. So come inside. Let's see if it's any good. I've heard mixed reviews on it. So here it is. Here we have the sweet corn and vanilla soft serve swirl. So it really smells like candy corn big time. I like that the cone is orange. So, oh, it's melting on me. Good old Florida heat for you, so start over here with dripping on me. That is so good. It definitely tastes like candy corn, for sure. So if you're not a candy corn person, probably not gonna like this, but it is melting all over the place. And it has a cute little bow. I love it.
I'm not even exaggerating. I was gonna film some nice B-roll so you guys could get like a good view of this ice cream, but I'm not even kidding you. Like maybe a minute later, it was already dripping, melting. Good old Florida heat for you.
Guys, that had to be the messiest ice cream I've ever had in my life. That is for all for me. I'm embarrassed to say. Walking into Liberty Square, they have even more pumpkins. Pumpkins, pumpkins everywhere. Even more Mickey pumpkins up ahead. So we are heading into Liberty Square, so you can probably guess what spooky activity is going to come next. When you do Lightning Lane, you miss all of this. These are too cool. When you touch it, it plays music. That is so cool.
Excuse me, ghosty.
you sit here long enough and watch her, you'll see her actually open her eyes and look at you. Let's see if she opens her eyes for us. Oh, she moved her head. Did you guys see that? Ah, there she is. Okay, here we go to the stretching room.
This haunted room actually stretching, or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Of course, there's always my way.
I remember when I was a kid, this was like my favorite ride. I was always destined to like spooky things. What can I say? Guys, do you think Disney will let me have these in my house? Probably not, but you know, it's worth asking. You never know. Unless you ask.
And marble busts from the greatest ghostwriters the literary world has ever known. We have all retired here to the Haunted Mansion. Actually, we have 999 happy haunts here.
Send us a message from somewhere beyond.
As we exit the Haunted Mansion and make our way back over to Main Street, there are more fall decorations. Disney has some of the best fall decorations, I must say. Although, I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to give it to Universal when it comes to the fall stuff. I love both, don't get me wrong, but in my opinion, Disney does Christmas better and Universal does Halloween better. Let me know in the comments if you guys agree or who you think does fall best. I absolutely love the Cinderella pumpkin, and I love how we have like the fall garland surrounding it. It is just so pretty. Because if you've seen Cinderella, you know that the fairy godmother turned the pumpkin into a carriage. This is just so pretty. I love how it twinkles. And what better view is it seeing that? And then the castle. What more could you want out of life? Disney and Halloween. So our next non-party treat takes us over here to Sunshine Tree Terrace. So we are going to be trying the sparkling sunshine. I cannot wait to show you guys. I have a mobile order, so I'm still waiting for it to come up. It closes at 10. It's almost 10 now, so it shouldn't be much longer, but it's basically orange cream soft serve topped with apple cider, and then it's rimmed with iridescent sugar. I am so excited. It's like fall, but make it Florida. Okay, so our order is ready for pickup. Okay, so we are going to be trying the sparkling sunshine. So like I said, it's orange soft serve with apple cider. So I don't know. Let me know in the comments. Are you guys more of an apple cider person or a pumpkin spice person? I mean, for me, like, why can't we be both? Why do we have to choose? That is so delicious. And I really liked it way better than that corn soft serve, candy corn soft serve. This is so good. Cannot go wrong with orange soft serve. Guys, this is insanely good. Now, you can get this at Sunshine Tree Terrace. Try this. If you're a fan of orange soft serve and if you like apple cider, try it. I haven't gotten to the apple cider part yet. I'll let you guys know once I do, but so far, the orange soft serve is on point. Oh yeah, so now I'm starting to finally get like the little bit of the tartness from the apple cider, and it mixes perfectly with this orange soft serve. This is a delicious treat. I'm considering this a fall treat because it's apple cider. And here I was, silly me, thinking, Brittany, you're never going to be able to finish this, especially not after that candy corn ice cream. But here I am doing just that, finishing it.
Oh yeah, so once you get down into the cup part, you really, really taste that bubbly apple cider. And it, like I said, it honestly blends perfectly with that orange soft serve. Of course, we got to drink up that orangey, ice creamy apple cider. So tasty. So besides those two treats that I've just shown you, for the most part, there's really not a lot of other treats. If you guys are really looking for this super cute, super themed pumpkin spice type treats, I do recommend that you come on a Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party night. However, tickets for the event are sold out for the year. So if you guys are planning to make a trip, definitely plan for next year. I will say this, the tickets are insanely expensive, insanely. So hubby and I decided that we are gonna skip it this year. Enter the Emporium. I'm gonna check out and see what kind of spooky merch they have, see if anything's changed since September. We've come a couple times, but now that we're getting closer and closer and closer to Halloween, I'm hoping we find some new stuff. So let's go inside, let's check it out. So right as soon as we enter, big Halloween display with a bunch of cute little Mickey lounge flies, Halloween themed, of course. This one is adorable. I would say this is on the larger side of lounge fly bags. This is going for $75, which in my opinion is not bad for this little lounge fly. I would actually totally buy this. This is so cute. I love it. And I've been on the hunt for a cute lounge fly. Here they have cute little Mickey pumpkin Halloween costumes. Guys, if I put this on Merida, my Roddy, she would literally rip this off and there would be fluff all over the floor. I couldn't pay my dog in treats to wear this. Okay, Disney, shut up and take my money. I love this Oogie Boogie glow-in-the-dark shirt. It's multi-layered, so inside it has this cute little, like, bug pattern. This would be so cool on a Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party night if you guys are attending. And this is going for $36.99, so a little bit more on the more expensive side for Disney shirts, but this is really cute and really themed. And then moving along with the Nightmare Before Christmas theme, we have some Jack and Sally ears, Oogie Boogie t-shirt, and down here we have a really cute little mug. A mad scientist looking for trouble. Zero and Jack. Oh, this is a cute little mug. This is $19.99. But wow. If you want your home to be fully stocked on Halloween, Disney definitely has you covered for sure. Pretty much all the same stuff that I've shown you guys from World of Disney, all the same Halloween type stuff. I may have shown you guys this one before. This is more like, oh, this is kind of heavy actually. This is a nice little Halloween hoodie. A lot of times Central Florida gets pretty cold the closer we get to Halloween. This one's really cute, and then this one is going for $69.99. On the back it just carries on that same pattern. Very cute hoodie, but like I said, it is a little bit on the heavier side. And the Crystal Palace is decorated so nice for Halloween with all of that gorgeous fall garland. Wow. This fall garland is so pretty. They really pay close attention to like the sunflowers and the autumn colors. These decorations are so pretty. And they even have a little pumpkin too, right in the front. How cute is that? And above Casey's, they have a whole bunch of cute little glowing, smiling jack-o'-lanterns up here too. I like that we have a shocked one, a happy one, an evil one. I can't really see what that one is on the left, but it's so cute. And then all the way up there at the top, they have some more fall garland. If you guys can see it, let me zoom in a little bit. Such beautiful decorations. And even more jack-o'-lanterns on Main Street USA above the Plaza Ice Cream Parlor. Even more jack-o'-lanterns to adorn Main Street USA. There are jack-o'-lanterns everywhere. I absolutely love jack-o'-lanterns. I love all the different expressions, and I love how they're always glowing. So in my opinion, the front of the park definitely has some of the cutest fall decorations with little pumpkin scarecrows. And then moving on over to our left, we have a really cute little photo op. And during Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party, they have little photo ops. They may add a little extra Disney magic. I will insert mine and hubby's photo back from 2019 right here, back when we did it. And it's so cute. I actually will stop and get a photo so you guys can see how it looks. And it's really cute with the castle in the background too. Hey guys, so that is going to do it for us today here at the Magic Kingdom. We had a great time. We had a great non-Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party time. It really was a lot of fun. They do have a couple treats, but honestly, if you want like the really, really cute theme treats, definitely come for a party night. But yeah, they had some cute treats, they did. As far as ride overlays, obviously they don't do that when it's not a party night. They also don't do any Halloween parades, so it's pretty much kind of, you know, like a regular park day with some decorations with a couple little treats sprinkled in there. If you like this video, definitely give me a thumbs up. Let me know what your favorite part of a non-party night is here at Magic Kingdom. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye!